everybody, and welcome to the first video on the new Goose V2. In this video series, I'm going to show you how to build a Goose step by step. But before we get to the build, I'm going to talk a bit about the design and the project history.
This was in 2014, me holding Goose V1. I sold the aircraft in 2016 and I still regret it. The Goose is a very fun aircraft to own because you can fly it both from land and from water. It's quite large, and because the wing is a two-piece design like the fuselage, it's very easy to take it to the lake or your flying field. So I figured if I'm building a new one, why not make some improvements on the design? This ended up in an almost complete redesign of the Goose. It all started with the same 3D model as Goose V1 you see here. I also wanted to do a new color scheme based on the US Army you see here on the pictures. It's very easy to do and something different. So here you see my 3D model in colors. I'm hoping my Goose will look like this in a few months. With the black underside and yellow wings, it should be very visible in the air. Using the 3D model, I made this construction. Here you see all the laser cut plywood and balsa wood parts. There are still flaps, but it's optional now. Made many improvements to the nacelles, cowlings, tip floats. All the fuselage formers are single piece plywood parts. The wing tubes are different. Also the rudder and elevators are different. Servo locations is different. As you can see here, the elevator is now controlled using a 90 degrees lever, so you do not have an external control cable, which always bothered me on V1. The tailwheel is a new design. It's all 3D printed parts custom for this model. It fits much better. You can also still use the Hobbycon King tailwheel, but this one is a big improvement. Also, the tip float mounting on V1 was never something I really liked. I even lost my tip float once. And here is the 3D printed tailwheel. It fits very nice in the laser cut parts. Also, a big improvement are new pre-cut planks. I found a new way to do it in the CAD system. You see some of my CAD work. Also did it for the hatch, so planking these areas should be very easy. So eventually I ended up with these cut files. Many hours of work behind the screen are in this file. So with all the cut files I went to RC Europe to laser cut the Goose first prototype. It's just amazing to see how quickly and easy the laser goes through the balsa with very nice clean cuts. So after a few hours of fun with the laser cutter at RC Europe, this is what I ended up with. These are the 3mm poplar plywood sheets. As you can see, they're all cramped and full with parts. These 3mm birch ply. These are the axle member parts, and this is 1.5mm aircraft ply for servo hatches and control horns. This is the 1.5mm balsa, mainly for the pre-cut planking, but also for the optional flaps. And these are all the 2.5mm balsa parts. These are the fuselage sides, wing tips, rudder, elevator, some parts of the cowlings and the tip floats, and obviously the wing ribs.
These are the hardware parts. vacuum formed dummy radials, pre-bent landing gear parts, 3D printed landing gear parts, screws, connectors, hinges, propellers, electronics, wiring, two motors, and again the laser cut parts and sheet wood for one kit. So the goal is to have all this turned into a beautiful flying Grumman goose in May this year. That's only 4 months away. I hope I can make it.
Thanks for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I hope to be back next week with episode 2. This is where I show how to build the main landing gear unit.